Hello everybody and welcome back to another War Thunder upcoming content video. We're going to take a look at a new closed beta ship. This is for the Soviet tech tree, which was recently added to the closed beta test. And it's a closer look at their light cruiser that they have. This is now the third light cruiser available in the game, one for each of the available nations so far, United States, Germany, and the Soviet Union. It's not the only light cruiser that we've seen. There's also a British and Italian light cruiser that was shown off once upon a time, and I'm sure they will be the ones that we'll get to play with when their tech trees are added to the closed beta, if they're all being added to the closed beta, which I would imagine. Obviously, this is one of the only interesting ships to me personally on the Russian tech tree, and despite the fact that in my coverage of the announcement for CBT, as much as I was like, I don't know, I was hyper in that video and I was just saying a load of garbage. And yes, my opinion still stands. I don't have much of an interest in the Soviet naval tech tree at all. That's not to say I'm not going to enjoy it or, you know, I'm not going to play it, because that's definitely not the case. And as I stated in that video, even though that in real life they were garbage, in War Thunder, that's just not how it works. Garbage things from real life can kick serious ass in War Thunder. Therefore, I'm interested in their big ships. And, well, I guess that's technically the point for all of the tech trees, but I'm not interested in any of their little ships. I'm not even interested in Russian destroyers. That's how little interest I have in the Black Sea Fleet. So now, let's take a closer look at this, and I'm not even going to try to say that fucking name, so for right now, we're just going to call it the Russian cruiser for the sake of simplicity, because screw trying to speak Russian right now. Okay, now, this is already in the game, let's point that out, for those of you that don't know, and it is available to anyone who has access to the closed beta test, which you can gain access to by purchasing one of the bundle packs, I believe. So, but otherwise, this is upcoming content for those of you that don't have access to the closed beta and are waiting for the open beta or full release of Naval Forces. Well, let's just get right in. So here we have a brief rundown of what this ship is. It is a heavily modernized light cruiser of the First World War, equipped with a primary armament of 4 B1K 180mm single cannons, which means it's a single cannon per turret, backed up with a plethora of secondary guns and torpedo launchers. The Russian cruiser is a Soviet light cruiser of the Svetlana-Class, there you go, it's my best pronunciation attempt, which were initially laid down before World War I for the Imperial Russian Navy, but saw completion and use under the Soviets. Captains will have the opportunity to try out the Russian cruiser in one of its World War II retrofits in the closed beta testing of War Thunder Naval Forces. And here, there's a history for anybody that's interested in history on this thing. We got two screenshots to look at. Here, let's take a look at this. And it's definitely not a bad-looking ship. And I think the only reason for that is because it's a ship, like a big old ship. Therefore, I'm able to appreciate it a lot more than any of like their little tiny riverboats with T-34 turrets, which I think look ugly as hell. But I still think that the winner for light cruiser in terms of visual is the German Emden-class light cruiser currently in the game. That's by far the most beautiful cruiser in my opinion, and that includes out of the British and the Italian cruisers that have been shown as well. Now, I'm hoping that when the Imperial Japanese Navy gets added, that they add a popular light cruiser, because there are plenty of Japanese light cruisers that I would melt over, and that could take first place for most beauty out of a light cruiser. Get a load of these guns, guys. Look at how big these things are. I mean, the turrets, at least, that they're connected to. These things are freaking huge! And, I mean, the ship is big as well. I mean, why wouldn't it be? It's a light cruiser. You can see the torpedo launchers there, various of the secondary dual cannon turrets. I believe those are also secondaries back there. And if you look really closely, you can see on turret 2 and turret 3 here, they have machine gun, like a little mini turret on top of the big turret, full of what I would assume machine guns. They might be autocannons, actually, presumably for anti-air fire. But leave it to the Russians to do something like that, right? I mean, I guess they had to make do with what they had. In War Thunder, the Russian cruiser will be the first Soviet light cruiser that participants of the Naval Closed Beta testing will have the chance to steam into battle with. Unlike other ships of the same class already present in the game, the Soviet cruiser features an odd combination of heavy cruiser firepower combined with light cruiser levels of protection and mobility. Yeah, so it has heavy cruiser firepower, the 180mm guns. So basically what they're saying is, it's better than everyone else. Because of course they would do something like that with the Russian ship in the Russian game. The feature that stands out the most of the Soviet light cruiser is its unusual primary armament, namely, the cruiser is equipped with four 180mm cannons, spread evenly across the ship in single turrets. As these cannons are larger than the usual caliber of guns found in light cruisers, captains of this vessel, on one hand, expect to deal a lot more damage to their opponents, but on the other hand, should be also vary of longer reloads and limited number of guns available. The complement of primary armament, the cruiser is also equipped with six dual 100mm secondary battery guns, located midships, plural. Due to their dual-purpose nature, these guns are capable of both engaging surface targets as well as enemy aircraft. However, the 100mm guns are not the only thing keeping the cruiser safe from surprise attacks from the air and smaller vessels. To aid with this task, the cruiser is also equipped with two single 76mm, two single 45mm, 10 single 37mm cannons, two single and two quad 12.0mm high caliber machine gun emplacement. So there's... I don't know where all those other guns are. I guess they're mixed in somewhere there. Maybe we'll get a closer look here when we look at some of the other screenshots. Apart from the blistering array of guns, the ship has... Apart from the blistering array of guns, the ship also has the capability to launch torpedoes off of each side of the hull, thanks to four triple 450mm torpedo launchers. Alright, and here we got a good... Spoilers! Spoilers, you twat! No, where'd the other one go? What the hell? It's not here anymore! Gaijin, what the hell? Ugh, I gotta refresh the page, damn it. Okay, there it is. You can see the size comparison. There's a tiny little tank down there. It's about damn time. Okay, that doesn't tell me shit. Alright, next. Alright, there you go. We got little turrets here. And then there's obviously, I would assume those are the machine guns. I don't see, like, all of these other turrets they're talking about. All these other guns. Because those are only single. The dual are in the middle, right? Let's see. You can just barely see them right there. Maybe there's something like... Oh, those look like spotlights, though. Can we use spotlights? Oh my god, Gaijin, please add spotlights for night battles. Holy hell, would that be bad fucking ass. Oh, there we go. There's some weapons up here. Okay. Right, those are definitely look like autocannons of some description. Then again, knowing me, they're probably not. And there's the torpedo tubes up close. I'm surprised that the Russians have a lifeboat. I wouldn't imagine the Russians to have a lifeboat on their ship. In terms of mobility, the cruiser manages to reach a top speed of 29 knots, 54 kilometers an hour, thanks to the 550,000 horsepower, if only, the 55,000 horsepower that its turbines manage to produce. The armor protection of the cruiser is also comparable to similar ships already present in the game, but has more advanced structure, with 76mm of belt armor and conning tower protection, and another 20mm forming the deck armor. The cruiser awaits new captains in the closed beta testing of War Thunder Naval Forces, so don't wait around for too long. Raise the anchor and set course for battle. All hands to battle stations. Alright, now... here we go. So we get to see some of the other dev blogs that they've done. So they've done some dev blogs on, like, these shitty little boats. But let's take a look on... If you care about the light cruisers, then here's a look at the... two light cruisers that are currently available in the game right now that you can play. For the United States, you've got access to the USS Trenton, which is the ugliest ship I've ever seen. And then on the German side, you've got access to the fucking beautiful Emden-class light cruiser, which is really, really nice looking. But as for the two that are not available in the game now, but were available in a previous testing session, we have these two light cruisers. This is the... I forgot what this is called, but this is the Italian light cruiser, which is also not bad looking. And then if we scroll down, we've got the HMS Enterprise, which is the British light cruiser, which is also not that bad looking. And that, look at that one, guys. Look, it's got dual cannons in the turret. Like, holy hell. So, there you go. Four total light cruisers in the game now. I'm no idea what the French would get for their light cruiser. I never really thought about it. What other nation are we missing? Well, Japan, obviously. Well, I said four, but there's seven nations in the game. Okay, United States, Germany, Soviet Union. Oh, no, there's five that have been shown off. Shit, okay. I was like, hold on a minute. Something's not right here. So, yeah, I don't know. I don't know anything about French ships. I don't know. Do they have light cruisers? I would guess they would. I'm sure somebody in the comment section will now go out of their way to tell me. So I'll have an idea of what they might have on their tech tree and if and when they'll ever get around to doing the French naval forces. I don't even know if they've done work on them yet. But chances are, since we've already seen the British and Italian light cruisers, I'm guessing they're probably going to be next in the test, I would assume, I guess. As much as I'm sitting here still patiently, mostly, waiting for the Imperial Japanese Navy to be added to the game, because I really want to fucking play some Japanese ships. And unfortunately, we still haven't really seen anything on them other than a handful of small boats and a destroyer, I think. I think that's all that's been ever shown. The Kuma or something it was called. I don't remember. It was quite a while ago. Anyways, guys, so that's the Russian cruiser. Let me know in the comments below what you think about this new light cruiser available in the current closed beta test and coming for all users when the test has ended. Is it exciting to you? Is it a piece of shit? Or do you not give a shit because it's the Russians? Or are you one of those weird people that want to be interested in the Russian tech tree simply because they're garbage? Oh, man, I've been waiting to say that. I seriously don't mean that. That's obviously just me being a twat again. But no, seriously, is this an interesting ship to you or not? I'll see your thoughts in the comments section below, and I will be awaiting the next news and or dev blog on some of the other Russian ships. Hopefully they take a look at some of the other somewhat interesting Russian ships. Like, I really don't want to look at another T-34 turreted ship. Like, maybe they've got a few, like, I don't know. I don't know what class of ship they are, but they've got a few which look like post-war ships, post-World War II ships, or boats, technically. And they're but they look really interesting. So if we got a dev blog on one of those, I'd probably appreciate that more than one of their weird armored river boats that looks very Russian. Like they just threw it together in an afternoon and said, oh, at least it floats. That's good enough for us. Fun fact, for her combat actions, the ship was awarded the Elite Guards title, making her one of only a handful of larger Soviet Navy warships that did so. Oh boy, I'm sure she did a whole bunch. She floated and she maybe shot her guns once. Maybe the history says something about it. Where's the history? After World War II, it was converted to a training ship. And it was used as a target ship. And it was sunk by an anti-ship cruise missile. Like, that's so weird. I mean, I guess it would be so far out of date by then, so they would just get rid of it. But, I mean, it's not just the Soviets that did that. You know, it's like every nation seems to want to sink their own ships by testing their own weapons on it. It's like, just leave it. Just leave it. You know, it could be used as reserves if, you know, something... whatever. I don't know. I guess it's cheaper to do it this way, to sink an out-of-date ship, than it is to build a whole new ship to test on, right? All right, fair enough. Okay, what the hell am I still doing this video for?